Chapter 149, Tyrannical Valley Immortal Spring Physique, 1. To a young cultivator, losing their Dao foundation would be a fatal blow. However, Chen Beijiao was able to do it in such a resolute and staunch manner. Such determination impressed the cold as icy Xuanhuan and also earned her admiration. This matter required a huge amount of perseverance. What happened? Dao child Shengxin wanted to marry you? This was within Li Kai's expectations. He understood the Tyrannical Valley Immortal Spring Physique more than anyone else. The people with this physique were always forthright and unyielding. This was the same with the ancestral grandmother of the Chen clan. When she was young, she was a very brash princess. Even after she became a mother, she was still soft on the outside but tough on the inside as she assisted her husband and educated their children. I wouldn't marry him even if I have to die, Chen Beijiao coldly said with an absolute tone. Originally, the Heavenly God sect had ordered for the Jade Valley country to marry Chen Beijiao to Dao child Shengxin. They were already engaged from before, so it was a natural progression. Plus, the Jewel Pillar Sacred School along with the Jade Valley country were both happy to become allies with the Heavenly God sect, so the marriage date was set. However, Chen Beijiao adamantly refused. In the past, she was already against this marriage, but this time, Chen Beijiao would rather die than accept this marriage. Either she would not marry, or her corpse would be the thing that gets sent. Dao child Shengxin did not try to save her at the evil-infested ridge, he chose to be cold-blooded for his own benefits instead. This made Chen Beijiao even more resolute and without any room for negotiations when she cancelled this marriage. Even though the Jewel Pillar Sacred School forced her to marry, since Chen Beijiao would rather die instead, what were they going to do? Marry the corpse away? This caused the two factions to turn against each other. In the end, Chen Beijiao destroyed her Dao foundation and gave everything back to the school. The reality was that this was with the protection of the Chen clan. Otherwise, she would have not been able to leave. Good, I shall accept you. Li Kai nodded his head and said. But, I won't take in people of unknown origins. After speaking, he stared at the two people dressed in black next to Chen Beijiao. At this time, the two who were dressed in black took off their hats. It was one man and one woman who had features resembling Chen Beijiao. These two were her parents, and this was a painful decision for them. She was such a good daughter, yet she ended up with this result. Father, mother, you guys don't have to worry about me. I will be fine. Chen Beijiao stood up to hug her parents who were unwilling to separate from her. At this time, she was still strong. However, she did not notice the tears glimmering in her eyes. Even with thousands of words spoken, separation was still an inevitable end. This scene caused a melancholic atmosphere, yet Chen Beijiao still tried to hold back her tears. This old servant will stay back to take care of young miss. This old servant is not a disciple of the Chen clan. Near the time of departure, the old servant said. That year, this old servant owed brother Chen my life and agreed to take care of his descendants, and so, I stayed behind. I can no longer listen to and follow your words anymore in the future, master and lady. He then bowed down to the Chen clan's husband and wife. Uncle Xi said too much. When my father was still alive, he told this nephew to treat Uncle Xi like a senior. With Uncle Xi taking care of Beijiao, I can be without worries. The Chen clan's couple quickly lifted him up. Finally, they bowed down to Li Kai and said. Our daughter will be relying on young noble Li. I hope that you will take good care of her. To the Chen couple, bringing their daughter here to be a maid for someone was a hard decision. It was difficult for Chen Beijiao to convince her parents. After sending away the couple, Li Kai stared at Chen Beijiao and said. From now on, you will live with Xuanhuan. As for what to do, Xuanhuan will teach you. As for Grandpa Xi, how about this? You can be the guest advisor of the Cleansing Incense Ancient Sect. As long as you swear loyalty to the sect, I will not mistreat you. Thank you for your guidance. I will keep it in my mind, the old servant said as he bowed his head. He didn't dare to underestimate this young man. He had seen Li Kai's methods, smiling while killing 10,000 experts. Even the ancient saint and the azure mysterious ancient kingdom were all trapped in his calculations. He was extremely optimistic about the abilities of this 16-year-old boy. Chen Beijiao left with Li Xuanhuan, and Li Kai told Gu Taizu to arrange a place for her and the old servant. The Chen clan Shi Gandang. Gu Taizu was shocked when he heard this news. He quickly and respectfully gestured before the old man in front. Brother Gu is too kind. That year, Shi Gandang had died. At this moment, this old man is simply just a nameless grandpa. Grandpa Shi quickly returned the gesture. The Chen clan's Shi Gandang being a guest advisor for the Cleansing Incense Ancient Sect made Gu Taizu fired up. At that year, Shi Gandang was a renowned fierce monster within the Grand Middle Territory. He came from a lowly background, yet during the difficult Dao era, he was able to become an enlightened being. One could only imagine how much perseverance and amazing talents he had. However, because of this, he also made countless enemies. Rumors has it that enemies were pursuing him 1,000 years ago. He was cornered with his last breath but he was saved by the master of the Chen clan. From then on, he never left the Chen clan, and outsiders never heard the name Shi Gandang again. From now on, you are a person of the Cleansing Incense Ancient Sect, Li Kai leisurely said. As long as you contribute, there will be a great life-changing fortune for you in the future. Even though Shi Gandang was a fierce monster, but in front of Li Kai, he didn't dare to be disrespectful. Even though others called him a fierce monster, Li Kai alone killed more than him at the evil-infested ridge. There was even an ancient saint included. If he was a ferocious monster, then Li Kai would be the king of ferocious monsters. Thus, after hearing Li Kai's words, Shi Gandang displayed a respectful attitude. When Chen Beijiao joined Li Kai's side, she also brought along new information and told him. I'm afraid that the Heavenly God sect is climbing up to the Azure Mysterious Ancient Kingdom. Rumors has it that Dao Child Shengxin, Long Xiangxin, already went on a diplomatic mission to the Ancient Kingdom. The reason why the Heavenly God sect was rushing a marriage with the Jewel Pillar Sacred School was because they wanted to showcase their most impressive power to the Azure Mysterious Ancient Kingdom to get maximum leverage. Here, Chen Beijiao worriedly added. If the Heavenly God sect was able to have a relationship with the Ancient Kingdom, then I'm afraid this is very bad for you and a cleansing incense ancient sect. With the Ancient Kingdom as their backing, the Heavenly God sect's power became even more formidable. It's only one Azure Mysterious Ancient Kingdom, not enough to reach the apex. Regarding this news, Li Kai was not one bit surprised, and he calmly spoke. If they are smart, then they can keep on being overlords. However, if they are not and block my path, then even an ancient kingdom will be annihilated. It's only one Azure Mysterious Ancient Kingdom. These words came out so easily and was without any hesitation. It immediately silenced Chen Beijiao, opening one's mouth and saying that they would destroy an ancient kingdom. This was not an ordinary arrogance. However, she was gradually used to Li Kai's arrogance, and such despotic words uttered from Li Kai was no longer boasting in her eyes. After coming to the cleansing incense ancient sect for a few days and getting accustomed to her living situation, Li Kai called for her and said, I have many rules, and Xuanhuan has already told you about them. Today, you will start over once again and make many vows. From now on, you will be my follower. It is not too late to turn back now lest your whole life will be chained by the vow. At that point, any disobedience would result in a punishment by fate. I have no regrets. Chen Beijiao continued. I will use my true fate for the vow. I will absolutely be without regrets. Li Kai nodded his head approvingly as Chen Beijiao performed a true fate vow. He then continued. You will start with physique refinement, the supreme immortal physique law. A Haoshan physique can also have an immortal physique law. After hearing Li Kai, Chen Beijiao was shocked. Anything out of my hand would be an immortal physique law, Li Kai said. You don't need to sell yourself short. Your Tyrannical Valley Immortal Spring physique at grand completion will not be weaker than any grand completion immortal physique. Your ancestral grandmother, with her Tyrannical Valley Immortal Spring physique, even looked down upon the entire world. Chen Beijiao was astonished not because of her physique, but because of Li Kai's last words. A grand completion immortal physique. She came from the Jewel Pillar Sacred School, so she knew the meaning of these words. At the school, there were ancestors with grand completion saint physiques. In their eras, grand completion saint physiques were nearly invincible. They won every fight and were unstoppable, so they were able to establish the school. As for grand completion immortal physiques, it was unthinkable. From ages till now, people who had grand completion immortal physiques could be counted on one's fingers. Some said that not more than 5 people, since the immemorial, had reached grand completion immortal physiques. Others said that it would not exceed 10 people. If her Tyrannical Valley Immortal Spring physique could reach grand completion and was comparable to a grand completion immortal physique, how frightening would it be? How do you know my ancestral grandmother was a grand completion Tyrannical Valley Immortal Spring physique? Chen Beijiao couldn't help but ask. This was not written down by the Chen clan as opposed to everyone knowing that the Chen clan had grand completion saint physiques. This was a well-known thing. One day, if you have children, would your children know that you were a natural-born Tyrannical Valley Immortal Spring physique? Would they know that you made a true fate vow? Li Kai said with a carefree manner. These words shocked the young heart of Li Xuanyan. Her charming eyes became wide open as she stared at Li Kai. She made a true fate vow, but did this mean that the Chen clan's ancestral mother also made a similar vow? Could it be that my ancestral grandmother was taught by a great master? You are the great master's descendant, Chen Beijiao movingly said. Thinking about how Li Kai knew that she was a Tyrannical Valley Immortal Spring physique while no one else knew about it, and thinking about how Li Kai knew the secret hand seals of the Chen clan, Chen Beijiao finally understood something at this moment.